Sponsored by Honda, Dorito, 1-877 Cars for Kids, Lunesta, Trump Hotel, Goldman Sachs, Bank of America, and FarmersOnly.com.
Thanks, Ken. As you can see, April showers are bringing May flowers. It's a sunny, sunny May week this week. As you can see, temperatures are in the mid-60s with a high of 74 on Wednesday, though there is a chance of some light showers Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. So, April showers aren't totally gone, but spring is up and running here. Mostly sunny and bright sunshine throughout the week, so there's a lot to look forward to. Thanks for that hard-to-get applause, Nicole.
How's that, Carol? Good enough for you?
Lackluster.
I'll try harder next time.
Well, everyone, it is lovely out,
just
so.
Like you, Carol.
Right, exactly.
Yeah.
I agree.
You would, so.
Well, I would.
Former Miss Philadelphia.
No one cares.
Well, some people do care.
Well, there's already a label at the bottom of the screen that says your name on it, so there's really no reason to repeat it.
Right, well, some of our viewers might be visually impaired, so some might view that comment as ableist.
Well, all of our viewers are able to perceive that you're a frigid ice princess. And anyone, regardless of visual or auditory impairments, can plainly see that. So,
well, even if my nose was fake, which it isn't, there's no reason to shame other women for receiving cosmetic surgery or resulting to insults about physical appearance, which are completely unprompted, despite a thinly veiled insult I said earlier. Anyway, everyone have a great
point taken, Nicole. But many viewers would agree that most women who get cosmetic surgery are trying to conform to an unobtainable heteropatriarchal standard of beauty, as evidenced by the male gaze in this rising political climate, and by the nature of having the financial luxury to perform such a surgery is privileged and arguably culturally tone deaf, but let us say.
Because it's my body, my choice, and I really do think we should get back to what's important here and tangible, which is the news, not the semantics and ethics of cosmetic surgery among women, specifically white women, specifically me, in this instance.
Well, Nicole, that sort of raises a unique question. Is the news really important?
Well, Carol, that probably depends on how you define the word important.
Important, meaning of importance.
Hey, I'm just trying to let you know you just tried to define the meaning of a word using that very same word, so.
Of substance. Of urgency.
Well, then by that definition, yes, I do think the news is important.
Well, yes, I do think the news is important. But on the other hand, I also think that a misogynistic, xenophobic, orange narcissist sociopath who has ties to Russia and multiple allegations of sexual harassment surrounding his entire career, who declares major news sources and other tangible and scientific facts fake, is our president. And I also think that his right-hand man, our vice president, is an anthropomorphized hemorrhoid who not only actively believes in, but advocates for conversion therapy and the destruction of Planned Parenthood. So when you ask me if anything feels important, nothing feels important. It feels like it's raining proverbial bullets and that the end of our civilization is upon us.
So is that to say, Carol, that by these factors that ostensibly nothing matters?
Great question, Nicole. Who knows anymore?
Point taken.
Hey, Nicole. You don't think there's a God out there, do you? Ortega, and I'm ready for the sweet embrace of death.
We just cut the fucking shit.
Go to the snow, come down the street. inactive participant in my own life. Everything happens to me and around me, even childbirth. I just let it happen. I'm successful disassociating myself from everyone and everything. I don't even have feelings. I just pretend to have them in hopes that if I try hard enough, one day I really will feel.
Ha ha ha!